recently, Garden Time was invited to a special event down at the International Rose Test Garden, and it's called Portland's Best Rose. And I'm with Rich Bayer from the Portland Rose Society, which sponsors this event. And so what went on that day?
Well, we invite, it's not an open to the public event, but we invite, today there were 104 people that were invited today from all walks of life. And for this one day, we have them take a ballot through the garden with the roses that we picked, and they select the rose, not by any rules that they have, but which one they think is the most beautiful. And different people have different opinions on what they think a beautiful rose should be, but we just add them, average them all together, and we come up with the ones that most of the people thought were the best ones today.
And which one the best?
Today, the winner was a rose called Smokin' Hot, which was introduced by Weeks Roses 4 or 5 years ago.
It was a pretty one. And you want to describe it a little bit?
Well, it's multiple shades of orange. And at this time of the year, it's the most beautiful when it's had cool nights to work with. In the summertime, it's almost one shade of orange. But right now, it's very bicolored. And the picture, I'm sure, shows that when you'll see it as part of this presentation.
Yeah, it was really beautiful. And so then we need to talk about the big spring rose show that was just a couple days ago during Rose Festival. And we had talked about it with you. So how did that all go?
Well, we thought it was a superb show.
Good.
We always brag about our show being the biggest in the country, which we really have no idea because most people do not count their roses. However, I watch the rose shows across the country that do. And if they get 250 entries, they thought they had a big show. We had almost 1,400 vases of roses that were entered in that show. So until someone says, you don't know, we're going to continue saying we still host the biggest rose show in the country.
Oh, that's excellent. Well, I hope you got to go see it. It was at the Lloyd Center. So don't forget to try to go to see that next year. We'll make sure that we give you the dates on the Garden Time website. And so, Rich, there was a winner for that show. So what was the winner?
The winner this year was very unique in the fact that it has sort of a strange name. The name of the rose is Robert Bruce. And it's special because the hybridizer, the man who did the sexual crossing of its parents, has been a member of the Portland Rose Society for the last 35 years. And he tends to name his new roses for his friends.
And who was the breeder?
Dennis Consma. And he has
wonderful.
A number of beautiful roses out, but right now he's extremely proud of that one.
Oh, I bet.
And he's extremely proud because it's the first time in the history of the 130 years that we've ever had a winner be also the hybridizer of the rose which won.
Oh, that is interesting. And really, it's such a great organization that puts on today Portland's Best Rose. So tell us a little bit about how we can get more involved.
Well, we would love to have people get involved. Unfortunately, with the housing situation as it is, people do not have the yards they used to have. And so a lot of people are prohibited from growing roses because they just don't have a space. But we are open to anybody. We've had a number of people in our Rose Society that don't have any roses. They just want to be associated with roses and with people that do grow them. We are open to anybody. We have no restrictions on who can join.
Well, if you are interested about the Portland Rose Society, you can always go to Garden Time. We'll have all the information about that website and about all the events that they do. Rich, thanks so much for all you do, and thank you for being part of the Rose Society.
It's always been a pleasure to work with you folks.
Thank you.
Yes.